Welcome to Engineering Python. This is a Python programming course for engineers. In this video, I will talk about the break, continue, and pass statements. The break statement will exit the enclosing loop in the middle of an iteration if a certain condition is true. Let's demonstrate this using an example. This program prompts the user to input a test score between 0 and 100. We use a while loop to implement it. Note the condition is always true. We ask the user to enter a score. If the score is in this range, it is a valid input. The loop will end and the score will be printed. Otherwise, the loop will print this message. The score was not between 0 and 100. Do it again. You won't get out of this until you enter a valid score. Run this program, enter a test score between 0 and 100. I'm trying to mess up with the program by typing in 120. As expected, the score was not between 0 and 100. Do it again, this time negative 10. Still no good. Do it again, this time 85. We're good and the program ends. The continue statement skips over the rest of the loop in the middle of an iteration if a condition is true. This program will print out only the positive numbers in a list and skip over the negative ones and zeros. This is a list. It contains temperature measurements above zeros and below zeros. We also have a zero. For each temperature measurement, if it's less than or equal to zero, we will continue. That means the print statement will not be executed. If it's greater than zero, that means it's a positive number. Then we will print it. As a result, we only printed these four positive numbers from the list. When the break and continue statements are used in nested loops, they will only affect the nearest enclosing loop. For example, we have a for loop, then a while loop. Inside the while loop, we check to see if some condition is true. If it is, we break from the loop. This break statement is enclosed in the while loop. And this is the nearest enclosing loop. So the program will jump out and continue to execute the code immediately following the while loop here. In this example, we have a for loop and a while loop. If the condition is true, we will skip over the remaining of the while loop and jump to here to check if the while condition is still true. The pass statement does nothing. It is usually used as a placeholder for the code that hasn't been written yet. For example, we want to define a function named function1. Its body is just a pass statement. We also have a comment that says, remember to implement this function later. Same thing for this class definition. Pass, remember to implement this class later. Okay, that was all about the break, continue, and pass statements. The course materials are available on YouTube and GitHub. You can watch the course videos in sequence. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. I'm Yong Wang. Thanks for watching.